digital artist from Mexico. On this tutorial, I'll teach you how to create your own basic emoticon set in Adobe Illustrator. All the keys and shortcuts I use will be displayed on the screen so you can follow along. Let's begin. The first thing we're going to do to create our own emoticon set is going to be to open Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. And I had already created mine, as you can see here. But if you don't know how to create a new document, I'm going to teach you very quickly how. You're going to go here to File, New, or press Ctrl N on your keyboard. And once you do that, a window like this is going to appear. For this project, I went here to web, and as you can see here, I'm using the latest version of Illustrator CC. So if you're using a previous one, well, in a different layout, this information should actually be the same. So for this one, I went to the web presets and select the most common one, which is 1366x768. And I made sure that I selected as my color mode RGB, because I'm not going to be printing this project. So I'm going to click hit close, because I had already created mine, as you can see here. So for this project, we're going to create 5 emotions, and we're going to do it using only basic shapes and really, really simple tools like the pen tool. And we're going to be doing minimal, or the most economical tools for this project, because we want to make this simple. And that's why I also am going to be using only 3 colors, because I think less is more. So I'm going to go here to my tools panel, and probably by default you're going to see this rectangle tool. But if you click and hold that click, you're going to see the rest of the shape tools. Now, one thing that I personally like to do a lot is go here to this little triangle on the right and click on it. That way I can deattach the window and place it near my canvas. And the reason why I like to do this is because this way I can click on the different tools in a very fast way. And also the ones that don't have shortcut are very easy to access like this. So we're going to be creating a circle first. I'm going to press L on my keyboard to access the ellipse tool and click. And then you're going to make an ellipse. In this case, it's going to be a circle that is 150 pixels width by 150 pixels height, and I'm going to hit OK. Now that I have done this, I have my circle. Now I'm going to remove the fill, because I don't need it, and change the stroke color to this purple one that I had already selected before. You can feel free to select the colors that you like, but try to use less colors, because as I said on the beginning, using less colors could be a very nice challenge that can boost your creativity. So you're going to go here to the stroke window, and if you don't see the stroke window for whatever reason, you can go here to window, stroke, or press Ctrl F10 on your keyboard. And once you do that, this window is going to appear, and here I'm going to change the stroke weight to 10. It's going to actually be pretty thick. And now one thing that I am seeing here is that it is creating it inside my circle. That is not something I want. So to change that, you can go here to align stroke, and you can see here that mine is on the middle, so it's aligning a stroke to the inside, and I don't want that, so I want to align stroke to the center. So I'm gonna click on that first one, and you can see how half of the stroke is outside and half of the stroke is inside. So now that we have our circle, we're gonna begin working on our first emotion. So I'm gonna press Ctrl plus to zoom in, and you can also press Ctrl minus if you want to zoom out. And then I'm going to press my spacebar to change my cursor into a hand and pan around by using the hand tool. Now I want to create 2 ellipses for the eyes, so I'm going to create here one by clicking here. And I want to make this one 18 by 21. Now I'm going to hit OK. Now this one, I don't want the stroke, I want the fill. So I'm just going to click here on these arrows to swap it. Now that I have that, I'm going to place it. I think right there is okay. So I'm gonna select this one to create the other eye, and while I drag it, I'm gonna press Alt to make a copy and Shift to make that copy on that same axis and move it around there. I'm gonna group these two by selecting them all, selecting these two and pressing Ctrl G on my keyboard. Or you could also select both of them and go here to Object, Group. Now that I have done this, I'm going to align these eyes to the center. So I'm going to select everything, click on this circle to make it the key object, And you can see how the outline has changed to something a little bit with a little bit more weight. And the reason of that is because now this is indicating that this is a key object. Now I'm going to go here on the top and you can see the align tools, or you could go here, window, align. And now I have all my align tools here. And I'm going to click here with horizontal line center to have them right there on the center. Now this one is going to be the happy one. So to do that, I'm going to go to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard. And then I'm going to zoom in a little bit to see it better. Make a point here, clicking here, make another one here, and you can see it's a straight line. But now while I click, I'm going to drag a little bit to make a little curve. And that's going to be that. Now I don't want this to have a feel, I want to have a stroke, so again I can just swap them. And I want to have the same width as the other one. So I could input the same values here, but I could also go here to my tools panel and find the eyedropper tool, or press I on my keyboard, and then click here on the other one. And as you can see, it's applying the same stroke weight that I had selected before. Now one thing that I want to change is that here on the caps, I want the caps to be rounded. So I can change that. Make sure that these two are aligned on the horizontal line. And now I have my happy face. Now, the next thing I want to do is create the next emotion. So I'm going to select everything and then I'm going to press Alt and Shift to make a copy. And now that I have my copy, I'm going to make the sad face by doing something very, very simple. I'm going to select this line that I created. And then if you can see, when I go to one of the corners, my cursor changed to these arrows. So I'm going to do that. And I'm going to just click there and rotate all the way to the other side by pressing Shift. So if you press Shift, the thing is that it rotates on angles are complete. So I'm going to rotate to 180. And now you can see that I have my sad face. Now I'm going to do the same that I did before by pressing Alt and Shift to make a new copy. And for this one, I'm going to make an expression that it's a face that is in love. So I'm going to delete this mouth. And one thing that I want to do is some heart. So to do that, I'm going to go to my rectangle tool or press M on my keyboard and click. And I'm going to create a rectangle that is 70 by 25. I'm going to hit OK. Now I'm going to fill this one. So I'm going to swap this and fill it with this red color. Then I'm going to create another rectangle, or actually a copy of this one, by pressing Alt while I'll drag it. And you can see that I made a new copy. Now I'm going to press Shift and go to one of the corners to rotate it to be horizontal. In this case, it was 270 degrees. And I'm going to select both these red shapes, click on this one to make it a key object, and then I'm going to align to the horizontal line left. So now they are sharing the same left. And here to vertical line bottom, so that they both share the same bottom. Now, while selecting these two, I'm going to go to my window, Pathfinder, or you can always press Ctrl-Shift-F9, and this window is going to appear. And in here, you're going to click on the first one that is called Unite. And when you do that, now you can see that my two rectangles are now one. Now I'm going to go to one of the corners, and while pressing Shift, I'm going to rotate this one 45 degrees. And I'm going to go to my Direct Selection tool, or press A on my keyboard, and select these two anchor points, and then these two anchor points while pressing Shift, and I'm going to round them all the way to the center. And now we have a heart. I'm going to place this heart roughly around here, and then I'm going to make a copy by pressing Alt and Shift to around here. Now I'm going to group these two while pressing Ctrl G, and I'm going to actually move them a little bit to the bottom to delete these other eyes that I have here. So I'm just going to move them right here, right back to where they were, or around where they were. And you could also always make sure that they are sharing the same center with the other eyes by clicking on them, making this one the key object, and just align them here to the vertical line center. and then we're going to create a little mouth to this in love face. So we're going to go to an ellipse tool or press L on our keyboard, click, make one that is 40 by 15 and hit OK. And now that I have this one, I'm going to change the color to purple. Make sure that I'm aligning this to the horizontal line center. And then we're going to go to our direct selection tool or press A on our keyboard and go click here on the top anchor point. And then while pressing shift, we're going to just bring it here down to around the center. So now we have a mouth like this. And let's, while pressing shift, move it a little bit to the top. And now we have our in-love face. Now to make an angry one, I'm going to actually reuse what I did with the sad one. So I'm going to select this one and press Alt and Shift to make a copy. And now for this one, all I want to do is make this mouth a little bit to the top by pressing Shift and move it to the top. And then I'm going to go to my pen tool or press P on my keyboard and then make a point here and another one while pressing Shift around here. So it's going to be something like this, and you can see here that I made this to have a width of 3 pixels, and maybe that's too much, so maybe I'm going to make this one by deselecting here to constrain the width and height to 22 here, 22. So it's actually not that. Alright, I actually think probably 25 would work better. So that's gonna be that. And I'm going to go to my rotate tool or press R on my keyboard. Click here on this anchor point and then just move this one around here to probably around there. This is around 30 degrees. And I'm going to make sure that I have the same width as before. And as you can remember, we assigned here a value of 10. But when I scale this one, that value got lost because I had selected that also the strokes are going to be scaled. So I'm going to go again to my eyedropper, press I on my keyboard, and click again on this one, or actually on this one, to copy those round corners. And now all I have to do is move it around here. Now you can see how this guy is really angry. And go right click, transform, reflect, to make another one. And if you click here on this little checkbox, you can have a little preview, and then just hit copy. Now you have the other one, and while pressing shift, so I constrain the movement on the same direction, I'm gonna move it around there. Now I'm gonna select both of them and group them by pressing Ctrl G, and again make sure that you align them to the center. Now you have an angry face. And finally, we're gonna make a surprise face. So to do that, I'm going to make a copy of this. So I'm going to select it and press Ctrl Shift. And now all I have to do is actually delete this. I'm going to actually reuse them, so I'm going to leave them right there. Just delete them out. So to do that, I'm going to actually ungroup them. So I'm going to go Object, Ungroup, or you can press Ctrl Shift E. And what I want to do right now is to go here to my rotate tool or press R on my keyboard. Click on this anchor point that is on the left, and then just rotate this one to probably around something like this, like 62 pixels. And now that I have that, I'm gonna delete this one because I actually want to make a copy of this one. So I'm gonna click on this one, right click, transform, reflect, and then make a copy. And then I'm gonna move it around here, select both of them, and group them by pressing Ctrl G. Make sure that both of them are aligned to the center. Move this one a little bit to the top because the eyebrows, when you are surprised, are actually not really close to your eyes. And I'm going to create another ellipse by pressing L on my keyboard or clicking here and just click. And I'm going to make one that is 23 by 20. I'm going to hit OK. And again, I want to swap this because I don't need a stroke, but I need a fill. And I'm going to go to my direct selection tool or press A on my keyboard, click here on this bottom anchor point and move it a little bit to the top by pressing shift. And it's going to be like that. Make sure that this one is aligned, and actually move it a little bit to the top. That's going to be it. And now we have our surprised face. So now that we have this, I'm going to actually select all these circles, the big ones, and press Ctrl C to copy them. Or I can go to Object, sorry, to Edit, Copy, or as I did before, Ctrl C. I'm going to create a new ledger by going here to my Ledgers window. And if you don't see that window for whatever reason, you can go here to Window, Ledgers, or press F7 on your keyboard. And then go here right on the bottom, you're going to see this kind of sheet of paper, and create new ledger. Now I'm going to place this new ledger that I just created on the bottom. And I want to paste the ones, the circles that I just copied before. So I'm going to click on this layer 2 and pressing, if you press Ctrl B, you're going to see that they are not being pasted where I want them. So I'm going to actually undo that. So what you want to do is go to Edit, Paste in Place. So I'm going to press Ctrl Shift B. And if you do that, you can see that now they are exactly what you want them. And to avoid actually clicking on the top ones, we're going to actually lock this layer. So layer 1, where you created everything, you're going to click right here to the next to the eyeball, and now it's locked. So now we're only able to select the ellipses that we just pasted. And I'm going to select all of them except the one that is angry, and change again the swap for the fill, and change the color to this yellow one that I had selected before. And for the one that is angry, I'm actually going to select the red I use for the eyes on the heart. So now that we have this, I'm going to actually unlock this one, then group everything, including the one, the ledger that we just had before. So I'm going to go Ctrl G, then on this one, Ctrl G, Ctrl G, Ctrl G, and Ctrl G. And you can see now the ledger 2 is empty now, because everything, when you group it, you actually bring it to the ledger that we had before. So what I'm going to do is actually group everything. So select them all, and pressing Ctrl G to group them. Now they are all grouped. And actually before that, I'm gonna undo that just so I can. As you can see, the distance between these, they are not even. So I'm gonna select everything and then go here and make sure that I'm not aligning to artboard, but to selection. So you're gonna change this one to align to selection. And then you're gonna go through to distribute objects. And in here, you have this one that is called Horizontal Distribute Center. And if you click that one, now you can see that the distance between these objects is the same. So right now, I'm going to group them, just as I did before, well, just as I was doing before, by pressing Ctrl G. And now I have a group. And now I'm going to change this align to, again, to artboard, to align to artboard. And then I'm going to go here to Horizontal Align Center, and then Vertical Align Center. And with that, we have our emotions. And just remember, if you, for example, in my personal case, I think it's too much space between them. So you could always go select your group, right click, ungroup it, or Ctrl Shift G. And then make probably one of these like closer by pressing Shift. And then again, you can select everything. Make sure that you are aligning to selection. And click on this little option, Horizontal Distribute Center. And now you have a better distribution that I think in my case is working better. Now I'm going to select everything and go by pressing Ctrl G and align to artboard. And just as before, you can change to Horizontal Line Center and Vertical Line Center. And with this, you can see how with really, really few clicks and only simple shapes, you have created some emoticons that really show the emotion that you are trying to represent. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.